Following chemical evolution, the second stage for the origin of life that was proposed by Oparin was called biological evolution. It also had three stages. So let us begin with the first, that is formation of prosarpines. Now, what are prosarpines? According to the scientists, that is Oparin and Haldin, out of which Oparin mainly believed that prosarpines can be defined as the sole living molecules that gave rise to the cells. Cells that form the basic structural and functional unit of any life. So according to him, the prosarpines were the base to form these cells. Now how does that prosarpine formation occur? Till now we have studied that the macromolecule was formed. Now these macromolecules, when underwent the aggregation and precipitation process, gave rise to organized structures that appeared as distinct bodies, that is, they did not got mixed with the seawater, which were called prosarpines. Like the macromolecule, that is the which is the base of these prosarpines, they are also involved, that is their main function was selective absorption. We can say the basic property of these prosarpines was selective absorption, that is acted as selective absorbing molecule. And therefore they did not got easily mixed with the seawater, but occurred as a distinct body. Since it is formed from the macromolecule, it is very obvious that these prosarpines contain various structures like proteins, nuclear protein, then nucleic acid, and many other such macromolecules. This figure depicts the structure of prosarpines that occurs as organic molecules acting as distinct in nature within the seawater or sea medium. Now these prosarpines did not directly got converted into cells. There was a mediator known as precells. That is, after prosarpine formation, they got converted to precells, which were also known as protocells. These cells were spherical in shape and contained a double-layered membrane. That surrounded such cells. These were the cells that, or these were the precells that exhibited reproduction by binary fission method. These cells were considered as a heterotroph. Why? Because such cells or such structures obtained their energy formed by the fermentation of organic substances. These were those organic substances that remained dissolved within the sea. In this manner, the protocells that were formed are anaerobic in nature. That is, the basic properties which was possessed by precells or protocells was, they were spherical in shape, possessed a double layer membrane, heterotroph, act as anaerobes, and was exhibiting the reproduction by binary fission method. Following this precells, the formation of cell occurred. Thus, following it, the formation of precells to cells occurred. In this, as we all know that the entire cell of any organism is basically made up of genetic material, that is DNA and RNA. Therefore, within such protocells, DNA RNA system got developed. These cells looked like a bacteria or virus. However, as we all know that DNA is the genetic material that has the ability for cell duplication and protein synthesis. On this basis, the life originated after a long process of molecular evolution. Since DNA had the ability for cell duplication, and protein synthesis, the cell formation occurred. These protocells, after this, got differentiated to form cells. Thus, differentiation occurred to form cells. In this manner, the main stages in the origin of life, as that was proposed by the Perrin and Haldane, can be defined or described as the primitive earth, that contained the elements, that is carbon, nitrogen, hydrogen and oxygen, which combined to form methane from carbon, ammonia from nitrogen and water with the help of oxygen, that is H2O. Then these elements together combine to form micromolecules, which then formed macromolecules, these macromolecules involved protein, then polysaccharides, nucleic acid, nuclear protein, then these macromolecules got formed into organized structure called coserviettes. Which then formed precells or protocells, which then got converted to cells that formed the basic structural and functional unit of life. Thus, this chart shows the basic Perrin and Haldane hypothesis for the origin of life.